Good evening, Danny here in the studio. It's Friday, and since October, I think, I'm having now every Friday Q&A session on the Instagram account on my stories. Feel free to join my Polish viewers and ask me questions. One of the questions I got was about road bike. So there was one girl who just bought a road bike. It is now good time for buying bikes, guys, because those sales sometimes are very good. And she asked, I just got a new bike. I've been having mountain bikes for my whole life. What should I do not to kill myself? And so I'm gonna give you four tips about road bikes. I think I already had some video telling you what it means when you switch from mountain bike to a road bike, but today four tips which can be very, very helpful. So guys, if you're mountain bikers, if you are one of those, trail riders, enduro riders, and you're loving it, try road bike. Don't just buy road bike right away, but try road biking because it is so different. It is light, stiff, super efficient, very, very fast comparing to mountain bike. I'm loving road bike. My main field is mountain bike and it's cross country, but road bike, not only for turbo trainer sessions or for training sessions, for speed and fun, is so good. And so, this is road bike. What happens when you sit on the road bike for the first time, if you were the mountain biker, is first thing, when you sit on the saddle, it feels way too low. Why is it so? Because road bikes don't need that much clearance. Example, this saddle for me is on about 102 centimeters height from the ground. My, let's say, my yellow B, which is the full suspension 650B e-bike, the saddle is 5 centimeters higher. It's a full suspension bike, it's a mountain bike zoned. So don't think that your saddle is too low. Still measure the distance between the saddle and the center of your bottom bracket. You might want to change it a little bit because most likely the crank arms will be shorter, which I'm going to show you right now. And so this is the crank arm, and on the inside surface of the crank arms you will see some symbols like 172.5, most likely for the large, or 56 size frames for the road bike. And if you're riding large on road bike, on mountain bike most likely will have 175, so 2.5 millimeter difference. That means on the mountain bike, your pedals here at this point will be higher, and then on the lowest point, but down there you don't see the other one, it will be 2.5 millimeters lower. That means you might wanna tweak something with the saddle height. Maybe you would like to have it a little bit higher because of shorter crank arms, a little bit. So that's the only thing you should know about. Otherwise, the saddle will feel very low when just standing with one leg on the ground because the clearance for the road bike is lower. Here's the second thing, and that's the tires. When you look at those, they will feel just too thin for the bike, and you will subconsciously think that there is no traction with these. I'm telling you guys, the road bike tires on the tarmac are much faster, not only faster, but grippier than your knobby mountain bike tires. The knobby tires from mountain bike, and also a less pressure, will kind of like swim on the tarmac, especially in the corners. These have much more grip, so do not be afraid of these. Of course, you're gonna be doing all the cornering slower than after a couple of weeks of riding on a road bike, but just don't be afraid of these. These are not having less traction on the tarmac than your mountain bike. No. The thing to remember here is not to put too much pressure. Most of the riders would feel just fine. It will feel compliant, will have better very good traction, and be efficient with about 95 PSI. About. You can put much more to many road bike tires, but just don't put too much at the beginning. Also, even if you're a very experienced rider, be sure that not always higher pressure means less rolling resistance. It's not always like that. It depends on the surface you're riding through. So just about 95 psi. This one says that minimum is 100. So I would just put minimum for my weight, 74 kilograms right now. If you're 80 kilograms, 90 kilograms, that would be maybe 100, 105, but not 130 psi. Don't be afraid of these. These are fast and these can corner very well if you learn it, and you're gonna learn it very fast. The third thing you don't wanna really change anything about is the handlebars, because they will feel super narrow comparing to mountain bikes, comparing to the modern 29ers, which have crazy long or wide handlebars. This will feel super narrow, so don't simply assume once again that you should change something just from the very beginning of your journey with road biking. Just have it. If you have the right size of the frame, the width of the handlebar should be okay, unless you are a pro rider or triathlonist or so. You're not going to be doing super precise bike fitting. Most likely the handlebars will be fine for you. They will feel narrow, but you will get used to it after, let's say, 5-10 rides. It really takes that small amount of time. You will see that this is safe to have such a handlebars, and it's aerodynamic, and it's really comfortable because you have so many positions on the handlebars. These are great. So don't be afraid of how narrow these can feel just at first glance. You're gonna be making friends with these handlebars on the road bike. Don't worry about that. Here is the fourth and the last thing, and that's the position of your braking levers. Why is it so? It's because on the road handlebars, as I mentioned, you've got so many different positions. So this is riding on the drops, this is riding on the hoods. You can ride like this, you can ride like that in the aero position. Sometimes you're gonna be riding like this, or like that, or like that. What you should learn is how to change the gears, right? And how to brake. And what's important is that you have the right distance between the lever and the handlebars. That means you want to have the right adjustment of your handlebars reach. Why is it so? Because it can sometimes surprise you when you just started riding a road bike that it will be maybe too far for you, and you won't have that much time for grabbing those. So you want to have these closer. Perhaps the brake set like this one is not the best for you. Maybe it stops too early. For the beginners, I would release some cable so that the brake would go a little bit further. That would be better, I think, because also when you are riding on the hoods, it will give you more leverage in braking. Maybe you don't have strong palms. For sure, you're not used to this system. So having just a little bit more of this will be cool. I'm going to show you how the adjustment works. Here is the reach adjustment on, for example, Shimano Sora shifters. You just open up the upper part of your hoods. There is small 2 millimeters Allen key screw. So I'm using 2 millimeters Allen key for adjusting the reach. So going clockwise, I'm making the distance between the lever and the handlebars smaller. Like this, you can see it moving. And now it goes back. I'm gonna show you like that. Oh. Now it's further away. So for the beginners, I would suggest having it a little bit closer so that your reach will be easy to reach, and then remember to adjust the cable tension accordingly. It's different on different shifters, but you should know there is an adjustment. So make sure these are just close to the handlebars, not that close, not too close so that the lever would touch the handlebars. You don't want to have that. But when you're riding on the hoods, on the drops, you want to have quite comfortable reach to your braking lever, and that's it. Then you are safe because you can shift, you can brake, you understand that the handlebars are okay, not too narrow, that the traction is great, your saddle is right, and now just go, guys. If you have any other suggestions for the newbies in road biking, let them know. Thanks for watching. See ya.